Hey everyone, it's Bill Jelen from MrExcel. Well, I've been working on Excel 2013, and I'm sure you want to see some of the cool things that are there. So, in this week, we're going to take a look at some cool features. This episode is called Excel 2013 Sign In. Okay, well, the first thing that's different about Excel 2013 is that we actually sign in, right? So I've signed in, I've connected all of my various services. So I've connected Flickr and YouTube and the SkyDrive and for Windows 8, Twitter and LinkedIn and all of that. So here's the amazing thing. I'm down here on my laptop, and this is not where I've been updating the books. I've been updating the books up on the desktop with the big screens and the comfortable chair and everything. And so I'm down here in the studio, and what's amazing is it shows me some recent files, and these are some files I just opened here a few minutes ago. But these files up here on the SkyDrive, these are files I've never opened on this computer. They were opened up on the other computer, all right? So I'm signing up there, I'm signing up here, and if I'm saving things to the SkyDrive, I can work on it up there, come down here, and work on it. I can, you know, go somewhere else and work on it. And it's pretty wild that I can just walk from PC to PC and pick up right where I left off, opening the same recent file. So it goes out and pulls it down from the SkyDrive. Okay, the first thing you're going to notice here is just the abundance of white. It's white all over the place, right? Big uppercase tab names here, which don't bother me at all, but a lot of people are complaining about that. And just white, white, white. What's up with the white? Okay, first off, there's going to be a version of this for tablet PCs. That Surface is going to have a version of Excel, and trying to touch this with the touchscreen, they had to get rid of what they call the Chrome. The Chrome is all the decoration that was back there in Excel 2010. So the Chrome is gone. This is a horrible, horrible theory, but it's my theory. When you're using a touchscreen, you get fingerprints on the screen. The fingerprints don't show up on the white background like they do on the old thing. And think about it, you're going to be touching these tabs over and over and over again. I think the white's there just for a better look. Some people think I'm crazy, but that's my theory, and I'm sticking to it. So what have they added? Well, all this week we'll be looking at some things that they added. Tomorrow we'll take a look at the things that they added that are new for people who are new to Excel, that don't fear the spreadsheet crowd. But today I happen to open up a list here of 66 functions that have been added to Excel. And a lot of these were added because of the open document standard. P duration and RRI, those are cool. Just, you know, you have a rollover IRA, you left one job, and you want to know what the actual equivalent interest rate is. You know, so 10 years ago it was this, now it's this. What's the actual rate? RRI does that. Formula text is one that I love. Arabic, I think, is absolutely hilarious. All these trig functions, I'm sure that Mike Gervin is going to love the fact that we now have the ability to do cosecants and secants, and or is it secant? It's been so long since I've been in math. A few new statistical calculations. You know, if you're a real geek, if you deal with binary at all, they've given us some bit applications here in engineering. A new one down here that you can barely see is formula. Is formula. This is going to be cool for highlighting all of the formula cells. And then we could spend an entire week talking about the web category. Those are absolutely amazing. So let's just run through a few of these real quick. It is 2012 right now, so equal Roman of this 2012 has been around for a long, long time. Well, now they finally added a way to go back. I think it's absolutely hilarious. Equal Arabic will take Roman numbers and convert them back to Arabic. I've been making fun of Roman for so long, right? And now the people at the Open Document Spreadsheet Consortium actually made them put Arabic in to go back. Absolutely hilarious. But the one that I love, so right now, you know, I'm updating Excel 2010 in depth, which is 1100 pages all about Excel, and there's 300 pages there of going through every single function. And so I'm adding these 66, but I have 400 worksheets that demonstrate every single function, and in those worksheets there's lots of formulas. And I would traditionally go in, edit the function, I would copy all the characters, Control C, go next to it, type an apostrophe, Control V, and then put that in italics. That way people could see what formulas I was using, right? Because I need to be able to see the results and the formulas at the same time. This formula text, equal formula text, I'm not going to say it was made just for me, but oh man, it has made my life so much easier. And now if this formula changes, or if I insert a row or something like that, the formula text updates, right? So, you know, right there, it changed. It's a beautiful thing, the formula text. We'll take some time and go through some of these other ones, but that right now is the one that is just making my life so much easier. Now, stop back tomorrow, and we're going to go through some of the new features that you probably have heard about, the ones that are there for people new to Excel, but then we'll go beyond that as well. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.